Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the acclaimed British actress, Claire Bloom.
If it is true that you appreciate most what you don't often have, then the people of Listvolsky, Russia, love the warmth of the spring more than any other people on Earth. The Siberian winters were long, cold, bitter, and mercilessly dark. Week after week, the snow would gather until the Sayan Mountains around the village were an unending blanket of smooth, white snow. The skies were almost always gray and lifeless, though there were occasional days when the north wind would blow, clearing the air to an eye-piercing blue. The people of Listvolsky lived simple lives. They didn't have a lot. A little wood for their fires, a little oil for their lamps. They didn't expect very much. Yet they always had hope. And they had their families, and that seemed to be enough. During the winter of 1917, the entire state of Russia had fallen into dark and tumultuous times, as the reign of the Tsars came to a terrible, violent end. What was to replace it? The people of Listvolsky didn't know. But rumors of marauding soldiers and war had reached the village, leaving the villagers with dark stories to fill the long nights. Anya was 8 years old when she became aware of the upheaval around her. Though she was young, she was particularly sensitive for her age, and she knew, sometimes more than the others, that a great danger was at hand. Through the long winter, she and her father would often sit around their fire, talking and listening to the cold wind blow outside. On these evenings, her father would sometimes look at her and pause. So much like her mother, the same bright smile, the same dark eyes. He loved her more than anything he had in this world. Though Listvolsky was but a small village, there was one thing they were famous for. You see, the village artisans created the finest Christmas bells in the world, the red brass producing the clearest sound one could hear. Because of this, Listvolsky had a Christmas tradition that went back many generations. Each year, the newest baby boy from the village was selected to represent the Christ child. On Christmas morning, he would be wrapped in a blanket and laid in a manger in the town square. 12 village girls dressed as angels were selected to stand around the child, each of them sounding their bells to ring in Christmas morn. The year she turned 8, Anya was selected to be one of the angels standing beside the Christ child. Out of all the children in the village, she was one of the few. As Christmas approached, she lay awake, the blankets pulled completely over the top of her head, dreaming of the morning when she would ring her own bell. For weeks, her father labored feverishly, knowing the final product had to be his very best work. Finally, just 3 days before Christmas, he brought her bell home. with Anya on his knee. He laid his tools on the table and, working together, they etched these words into the smooth metal on the inside of the bell. For my angel to ring on Christmas morn. Anya watched, her eyes blazing as her father etched the words. Then she picked up the bell and held it as if it were made of pure gold. Turning to her father, she put her slender arms around his neck. I really want to ring my bell this Christmas morning, she said. He nodded at her happily. I know that you do. I love you, Father, she whispered as she clutched her bell. That night, they came, half an army, half a mob. They ripped through the village with a dark and hateful fury. They killed and they randomly destroyed. Then they rode away on their horses, their torches illuminating the night. Morning found Anya's father weeping over his child. He had wrapped her in a blanket and held her until her tiny body was cold. As the glow of the fire faded, he looked up and cried, God, why my daughter? Why my child? For he sat alone on his wooden chair. He didn't eat. He didn't sleep. He hardly had the energy to breathe. Afraid of the anger and the pain that consumed him, his soul cried out in anguish and loneliness. Enveloped by such darkness and without any strength, he did the only thing he could. Moving beneath his pain, toward the small light still buried within him, he whispered, thank you, God, for letting me be Anya's father for 8 years. Thank you for the afternoon she helped me etch the words on her bell. For a moment, his simple acceptance seemed to soften his grief. The night passed and the day finally came, finding him still alone. He listened to the village outside his home come to life, the sound of people, some of them singing, then children's voices from outside. Hard as their lot had become, the villagers knew they had to go on with their lives. He forced himself up and turned toward his cottage door. Numb and silent, he walked slowly to the village square. Gathering with the others, he knelt at the manger of the Christ child, then lifted his eyes to the angels, each of them holding a bell. And as the young girls started their ringing, he listened to the pealing of the bells and knew that the message of Christmas was real.
Thank you.
The sound faded slowly, and the silence of the mountains returned. The villagers waited, reluctant to break the spirit of that Christmas morning, but the cold eventually drove them back to their homes, the sound of their footsteps muffled by the new snow, leaving Anya's father alone at the manger. He turned and started walking away from the square when, lifting his eyes to the morning light, he suddenly stopped. He didn't see her, but he knew, somehow, he knew that Anya was near. Then he felt her whisper the message she wanted him to hear. He was born, Father, so that I might live. I'm still living, Father, and I'll be waiting for you. He fell on his knees in the snow, overcome with relief and gratitude. A sudden warmth seemed to fill him as her words touched his heart. Ring the bell for me, Father. Ring it every Christmas morn. He was born and he lives now. So think of him, think of me, and ring our bell every Christmas morn.